wonders why Haiti was identified for the Hand in Hand initiative. You know that this is the poorest country in Latin America and Caribbean region. It's a low-income country, a small island development state, and the population growth is higher than the GDP. We have multiple crises: socio-political instability, security issues, economic crisis, food crisis. Currently, we have 40% of the population suffering different levels of food insecurity. And it's a country that is exposed to climate change and natural disasters. We have recurrent hurricanes, cyclones, earthquakes, and drought. Second thing is that the FAO in Haiti is committed to work closely with the government, the private sector, the civil society, and the donors community in order to better target the poorest and most vulnerable communities through the integrated approach of Hand in Hand initiative. And then third, we have a close collaboration with headquarters, the regional and sub-regional offices, in order to ensure that we can mobilize the necessary expertise and that we can link national development initiatives with the regional and global policies. In order to roll out the Hand in Hand initiative in the country, we have undertaken several steps. So first, I briefed the Prime Minister and the Minister of Agriculture and Environment about the initiative. And the Governor of Haiti has sent a letter to the Director General of FAO in order to express interest in joining the Hand in Hand initiative. Then we also contacted selected governments and development partners that are interested in food security and agriculture and investments in the food systems. Some countries like Cuba, Brazil, Dominican Republic, Mexico, Panama, Spain, and the European Union have already expressed interest in joining the initiative. In coordination with the Spanish cooperation, we have set up an alliance for food security and nutrition in the southern part of the country. So we have with us three NGOs and the Ministry of Agriculture in this initiative, and we have already mobilized a budget of $1.5 million. We have also mobilized internal FAO resources through the Technical Cooperation Program, and we have elaborated the project together with the Hand in Hand Task Force. You know, it's composed of headquarters, regional and sub-regional colleagues, together with the experts in our country office. On the humanitarian side, we have also elaborated the Emergency and Resilience Response Program. This is part of the big efforts of the humanitarian community in 2020 to address food security crisis and also the COVID crisis. We are targeting 1.2 million people, about 240,000 households, and the requirements are $93 million. So far, we have mobilized already some funding for this program from different donors and also FAO internal resources, about $4.3 million. And we are currently discussing with donors additional funding for about $8 million. Hand in Hand is a country-owned approach and connects economic, social, and environmental dimensions. It combines economic, statistical, spatial, and analytical tools and data to target and foster development-oriented investments. I think it's a new approach that will facilitate the harmonization of activities at the country level, using all FAO knowledge and expertise to make development actions more responsive to the real needs of the population. The initiative is an initial phase in Haiti. It's early to draw full conclusions, but we know that what we need is to show solid results to get everybody full on board, including the government and more donors. We aim to roll out this Alliance for Food Security and Nutrition in the southern part of the country during this month of July. Also the TCP project that I mentioned is being initiated now. What we also want is to support and engage other interested actors in order to elaborate more projects and proposals that are feasible and responsive to the real needs of the population. So the next steps will focus on measuring the impacts, systematizing the learnings, and replicating the experience in other areas of the country. FAO Haiti aims to have a more global approach and broaden his geographical focus to achieve more effective actions and address the complex problems of extreme poverty and food insecurity in the country. In the medium long term, the initiative can contribute to achieve greater cooperation and partnerships among the stakeholders. FAO Haiti can play a crucial and central role in this process, given his capacity to provide the necessary technical support. Positive impact, I think it's very important to listen carefully to all the actors, from producers, markets, consumers, and decision takers at local, regional, and national level. The listening process will allow to define projects and proposals that are feasible and responsive to the needs of the populations. I think it's important that programs and projects reflect the priorities of the country and vulnerable populations, respond to the market forces, are in line with national policies, and reinforce the existing systems and institutions to make them more resilient to external shocks. As we know, funding and building infrastructures are not enough to ensure sustainability and resilience. The ownership, full engagement, and commitment of all the actors, including the government, is also very essential. Thank you.